Okay, our next question comes from Marcus, who's asked, what's the process for tuning variable camshaft timing for two scenarios, low load cruise for fuel economy and high load, high RPM for power? Okay, so the process of tuning variable cam control is or can be quite time consuming, and it really becomes another iterative process. The important thing to understand here is when we adjust our cam timing, what we're trying to do here is optimize the cylinder filling. We're trying to optimize the engine's volumetric efficiency. So we kind of go around in a circle here. We make an adjustment to the cam timing, but because that's affected the volumetric efficiency of the engine, or in other words, how much air is flowing into the cylinders, we will then likely also need to adjust our fuel delivery to maintain a consistent air fuel ratio, and potentially also our ignition timing to optimize the ignition. So it does become an iterative process of going around in circles with those aspects. In terms of tuning those two scenarios you've talked about, let's talk about full throttle maximum power tuning for a start. So really what we're looking for here is to optimize the torque that the engine is producing at each RPM. And we're going to run the car, we're going to make a change to the cam timing, we're going to run it again, and we're going to see what the result of that particular change was. If we've picked up power and torque, then we're going to keep going in that direction until we find that torque stops increasing. So it's a relatively straightforward process, and in a way it's really not too dissimilar to what we're doing with our ignition timing. If we get to a point where we make a change to our cam timing and the torque reduces, we're going to go back to where we were. At cruise, it's not too much different. We're generally going to find that if we're talking about an intake cam here, under lighter load, we're not going to want as much advance as we want at wide open throttle. Again, we're using the dyno to help tell us which way we need to be going here. If we're looking for fuel economy though, what we're going to be doing is watching our air fuel ratio as well as the torque output from the dyno. And what we may find is that the dyno actually shows a fairly consistent torque output over a reasonable swing of our cam timing. And in this case, if we're still producing the same torque, what we're going to be looking for is the point where our air fuel ratio measures richest. The reason for this is, as it goes richer, provided we're still making the same torque, it gives us the ability to remove fuel from the table, get back to our target air fuel ratio that we actually want to run. If we're still making the same torque, we're basically making that torque, but with the benefit of using less fuel to do so. If you want to know more about EFI tuning, click the link in the video description to take our free 6-part series of lessons that will show you the fundamentals behind EFI tuning.